When it comes to equality, when it comes to social justice and activism, like, what can someone like me do with what I have right now, where I am?
I feel like I'm coming not to some backwater, but to the cutting edge of all the core stories of our time. Whether it's stories of land and water and wealth and extraction or monopoly or health and addiction and polarization.
You know, we want people who are 45 to work with people who are 25, to work with people who are 65. We want them all working together. There's a lot of knowledge and power there.
There's a little shop that we're gonna stop at. They were selling at the time out on the front, watermelon, corn, and Confederate wind flags. And I told him what I did. And he said, well, I'm guessing that we are on polar opposites of the political spectrum. And I said, maybe. Let's find out.
What are the fears that you have if that division doesn't stop, if it just keeps getting worse?
If it keeps getting worse, I'm honestly afraid that there will be people ending up in fights. And when I grew up, a fight was a fist fight. Now it's knives or guns.
The work that is happening here in Idaho is an attempt to mobilize a kind of mass base of Americans to confront the challenge of autocracy in our time, the rise of authoritarian movements.
And the reason why I love this type of states is because I believe that there's hope, that there's community, there's so much to build, that sometimes it's not gonna happen like it happens in Chicago or in another, you know, urban area. But there, I think there's so much potential.
It's about changing this perspective of the governance, you know, and how to actually look at young people being a transversal domain.
This particular movement, it's small, but it's growing, and you can feel it. Like, you can feel the rumble starting because there's a change happening, and people want change.
Mm-hmm.